Good day, friends. It is me, HLModTech, and I am back with another fun, fast Tinkercad tutorial. So let's get cracking. Friends, today we are going to make our first Tinkercad house. Start by clicking Create 3D Design. If you've never signed into Tinkercad before, I always choose Sign In with Google. Friends, we're going to name it. This is going to be called House, and I'm going to call it Day 1. My goal right here is to teach you a ton about Tinkercad in just a few minutes. So the first thing we're going to do is click on this cube and bring it out. We're going to set it on what's called the work plane. It is measured in millimeters, and here is our first skill. Hold down shift on your keyboard and stretch that as big as you want, but then we're going to type the number 40 out here. So that cube, if we look at it, is 40 on every side. When you click, you can easily see those measurements. We're going to make a house that is 40 this way, but we're going to change this number to 70 and press enter. We're also going to change the height to 35 and press enter. That is going to be our house. Let's also make it brown by clicking the colors and switching it. Now we want our house to have walls. Friends, we're going to do that really quickly. I want you to hit duplicate or do Control D. Pull the second one away. I want you to click on it and make it a hole, and then we're going to change some numbers. Where it said 70, notice I'm clicking the red one, and we're going to type 66. So we took away 4. We're going to take away 4 over here. We're going to type 36 and press enter. We're going to change the height to 40 so that it's taller. That makes it easier to grab it and get it close to our shape. And then we're going to make it perfect by selecting the two of them. Click and drag. Click the align button, which is the letter L. And we want the middle from the front. So notice I'm looking at it from the front. There's the middle. I'm also going to look at it from the corner. This is the awesome view cube. And bingo, that one's in the middle of those three. That happened automatically because of how we set it in. And we're ready to group them. Friends, you have just made a house with walls. How cool is that? Now let's cut in a door. We're going to do that by bringing out a hole. We're going to set it down, and we're going to use these black handles. Notice as I stretch, it only goes one direction. I'm going to tell you the perfect number is 10 wide. And then for the height, I'm going to tell you the perfect number is 15 and press enter. We're going to take this and put it in the house. And we're going to put ours right in the center. Once again, select it all. This time, press the letter L, which is the shortcut for a line. And we want it to be in the middle. And then you want to look at it from the top, which we could just click here. And we want to make sure it pokes through. Now we can select those two items, and we can group them. And you just cut in a door. Now let's fill the door with a door by bringing out another cube. Remember those magic numbers? 10 and 15, and our walls are too thick. So we can just hit the number 2 and press enter. Pick a color that we think is cool. I'm going to make mine a light tan, and then let's align them by selecting them both. L for align. Let's look at it from a corner. I want to click on the building so it's the boss. Notice we already have the middle. We just want to move to the front edge. Bingo, your door is added. Now friends, let's add a window. This time we're going to use what's called the hole cube. Now because of cruising, we can set it on the wall. If you set it on the ground accidentally, that's fine. You can just press C for cruising again, or pick the cruising button and just grab one of the cruising buttons and put it on the wall. Now currently that is a huge window, 20 by 20 on a side. Friends, I'm going to shift squeeze, and the number I want to type in the box is 10 and press enter. Because I held shift, it's 10 on every side. We want to push it through the wall, so we're just going to use that cone. Or you could do control down arrow, control up arrow to move it on that work plane. Now I'm going to let you pick where you want to put this. I'm going to just use the arrow keys. And I'm going to put it on this side and close to the edge. I'm making sure I don't cut through. Notice I just did a right click drag, which is the same as using this view cube to look at it. Now I'm going to click on this and do Control D, which is duplicate. And if we do nudges, it goes 1 millimeter at a time. If we do shift nudge, it goes 10 millimeters at a time. If we want these to be perfectly aligned, we can shift select them. Notice it says two shapes, and I'm going to group them. Now I'm going to select the building and the windows. If I choose a line, click on the building, I can then hit the middle and they are aligned exactly on both sides. I'm going to change my up and down by doing control up, control and down to get them exactly where I want. And when I'm happy, I'm going to select the windows and the building and hit group. Bingo! A house with windows and a door. This is where I want you to start having more fun. Add your own windows. Once again, bring out your cube. If you want to shift squeeze it to size 10, you can. If you want to stretch it to your own crazy numbers, you can do that as well. Of course, push it through, and when you're happy with your new custom window, Control G to group that as well. Let's fill our window with glass really quick. Watch this. Bring out a cube with cruising and set it on that edge. Now remember, we know this is 10 by 10, so I'm going to shift squeeze and I'm going to type 10 and press enter. I do need to make it the right thickness, so we're going to change that thickness to 2. Notice you click the corner, hit the 2. I'm going to pick a blue, this one right here, and then I'm going to use the nudge key to get it out where it needs to be. Notice it fits in there nice and dandy. If you want to align it to the front edge, we can select them, choose a line. Note I'm saying I want it to come to the front edge of the building. If you hit F to fit view, right now it is light blue. Friends, if you hit the letter T, it is transparent and you can see through it. How cool is that? Now you may note it is not perfect in that hole. Watch this trick. Hide, click work plane, set it on this wall, choose show all. Now when we click on that item and do D to drop, it snaps right to that edge. I'm gonna hit work plane, click out here on the blue and put it back in place. I want to put a window over here, correct? Control D. W for work plane, and we want it to drop on this wall. Hit the letter D, and bingo, you have just dropped your window in. Friends, I'm going to show you one more way to solve this. W for work plane. Put it back on the ground. Ungroup your building. Notice this is the perfect size, right? Let's do duplicate or control D. Make the second one red, and here's the secret sauce. We're gonna lock it. Now that red one cannot be adjusted. If we regroup, notice it says three shapes, but when we group it, it only groups two. Check it out, there is our red one. We can now unlock it. I'm gonna change its thickness to 2 and press enter. And then we just need to align it. Select those two shapes. Notice it says 2, click align, and we want it to come to this edge right here. Let's make it the blue. I liked that one. And once again, the magic sauce, T for transparent, you can now have windows that you can see through all the way around your house. Now, of course, friends, you can add more windows and more doors. I just want you to have the technique. The next technique I'm going to show you is the roof. Once again, because of cruising, click, drag, bring this out, and check it out. Set it on top of the building. That's how easy it is to add a roof. When you want to stretch this, I recommend the black handles. I'm going to simply stretch this so it goes all the way across, and I'm going to stretch it all the way back. Looking at things from an angle gives you a better shot at finding the right handles. Once again, we can raise it up so it's the right height, and you can easily adjust to get your roof looking exactly the way you want. I'm going to delete that quickly, and I'm going to show you just how to put it in the other direction. Once again, bring your roof out, and we're going to use the rotation handle. It is right here. Now, if you rotate inside the circle, it goes 22.5 degrees at a time. Notice that would be perfect. If you bring the mouse away, it goes 1 degree at a time. And then here's another magic trick. If you hold shift, it only goes 45 degrees at a time. So it's real easy to get that angle. You can then bring your roof over. Once again, grab those black handles and stretch them so they go exactly the way you want. Just a quick note, if you use the white handles two directions at once, that can be tricky. I'm going to do Control Z to undo that. Of course, friends, there is a ton you can do to make this cooler. Right now, I'm going to do one last align, shift select align, and I want to make sure it's in the middle with the building being the boss. There's the middle that way. And I'm going to look at it from this back corner, and there's the middle that way. Please have fun. Make these cooler. I'm going to wrap this up so you can see what to do when you're finished. The first thing I like to do is go to settings and pick a cool background color. Then I like to shut off the grid and click down here. You can see that is nicer for taking cool screenshots. And then finally, don't forget you can click on the Tinkercad workspace. Click on your project, choose properties, and you can share it with the world. Of course, give it a fun name. If you've got one of my projects, it will say tutorial coming soon. There will be a link there in a moment. Of course, here you can find my YouTube channel and my webpage. Give it some tags. Notice mine says house, and then if you want me to see your house, if you ever type HLMT23 and press enter as one of your tags, I search that every day, and of course, I'll give you a reaction. Finally, make sure you hit public, and then I always choose attribution, no derivatives, because I want you to come up here, follow the tutorial, and gain some epic skills. When you hit save changes, the whole world will be able to see it. Real quickly, let me show you how that works. If you click up on gallery, it will take you to the staff picks. Friends, always make sure you check these out. If you think what the user has created is fantastic, make sure you give it a reaction. You can also shut off the staff picks. And you will instantly see everybody else's amazing designs, including your own. And everybody can click on these and give them reactions. They can like, they can say awesome, they can say wow, give it a staff pick ready, or keep going. I think this club sandwich is absolutely fantastic. I'm gonna give it a like. And check out this fantasy sword. Oh my gosh, that is awesome. Of course, friends, do remember there are also cool designs in circuits and code blocks. Friends, as I wrap up, let me remind you about my website, hlmodtech.com. I've got the page dedicated to Tinkercad with a ton of awesome categories, and then right below it, the first day lessons. These are great for anybody that's just starting out in Tinkercad. Friends, I also want to highlight the super cool built-in messaging. You can click that button, add your question, comment, or suggestion, and reach me almost instantly. Friends, I do also want to highlight the link to the Tinkercad community Discord. As you can see, there are more than 600 members, and it's a fantastic place to talk everything Tinkercad. Finally, friends, of course, if you enjoyed the video, please give it a like. Please also hit that share button so more people can learn about HL ModTech. Of course, friends, you absolutely make my day if you take time to leave a comment down below. And if you haven't subscribed yet, what are you waiting for? Smash that subscribe button. And last but not least, hit that notification bell if you want to be the first to know when there's a brand new video from me, HL ModTech. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.